Tears and anger at Alberton as the axe fell on coach Matthew Primus and president Brett Duncanson. But even on one of the darkest days in the club's history, those left at the helm refuse to accept there's a crisis. Reporter James Wakeland joins us live from Alberton Oval. James?
Beck, Matthew Primus was clearly devastated by the club's decision to sack him less than 2 years after they appointed him. He said he'd hoped to take the club to success over the next 10 years.
Shattered and emotional, Matthew Primus's 15 years at the Port Adelaide Football Club comes to an end.
Pretty upset about it. I think we're on the right course. I think we're showing some improvement.
The 37-year-old admitted he could barely speak as he addressed shell-shocked players for the last time this morning before talking publicly.
I understand how ruthless this industry is. And how it's a high-performance industry and you've got to perform at a certain level week in, week out, and you just can't take your foot off the accelerator.
The former club captain had hoped to coach on next season, but the CEO and board decided after Saturday's humiliating loss to the Giants they'd seen enough. President Brett Duncanson, another casualty.
Consequently, given the last 24 hours... I've informed my board that I resign.
Chief Executive Keith Thomas now left to defend a club in turmoil.
There's no crisis. It will go on. And it'll go on in great shape. Today's decisions are about ensuring that occurs.
Down at the port, flags are at half-mast and fans are hurting.
I'm just disappointed in the bloody whole situation. I think it's a knee-jerk reaction for starters, getting rid of Primo this close to the end of the season.
I reckon it stinks myself.
Well overdue as far as I'm concerned.
Assistant Gary Hocking will coach the final four rounds. Primus visited at home by Coaches Association boss Danny Frawley, who'll help maximise his payout from a club that has now axed two coaches in three seasons.
I love the industry, I love football. I want to get involved with it, I want to be involved with it, so we'll see what plays out.
Now, interestingly, Matthew Primus did not hold his press conference at the same time as when President Brett Duncanson came out and said that he too would be leaving the Port Adelaide Football Club. Now, instead, CEO Keith Thomas was there with Brett Duncanson. They had the Port Adelaide Football Club logo behind them. They had the sponsors' names behind them. And by the time Primus came out just after that, all association with the Port Adelaide Football Club had been completely removed. Now, Primus too said that he did not want any board members in the room when he spoke. He also did not want any employees there too. That was mainly to keep his emotions in check after what had obviously been a very difficult couple of days. Now, if you want to have your say on what you think of the sacking of Matthew Primus, you can get onto our Facebook site and tell us what you think. Back to you, Beck.